Good morning friends, I am Srishti Jain and today we are going to discuss another set of 5 questions of finance. If you like my video then do subscribe to our channel for more regular updates. I'll be making more such videos on finance for you. So today's topics are really interesting and I'll be mentioning that what are we going to discuss. We are going to discuss the various types of tax systems. Then we are going to discuss the currency basket and SDRs. Next, we'll study the difference between sterilized and unsterilized intervention, which is very, very important. Then we are going to discuss the difference between liquidity adjustment facility and marginal standing facility. And lastly, we are going to do yield curve. So these are the topics for today. I hope that you will like my video. So starting with the first question for today, this question says tax systems can be distinguished by the effect they have on the distribution of income and wealth. Which of the following tax impact the most to the low income individuals? So you have to tell me that which of the following taxes impact majorly to the low income individual group. So one by one we will be understanding different types of taxes in the next slide so that we are in a better position to answer this question. So firstly we have regressive tax. Regressive tax is a tax which is uniformly applied and it is characterized by a less than proportional rise in the relative burden. Now for example, there is a packet of biscuits here and there is a low income earner and a high income earner. Low income earner say rupees 100 and a high income earner say rupees 10,000. Now on this packet of biscuit, indirect taxes are there in the form of GST. So for example, rupees 10 is charged as indirect tax. So if low income earner is purchasing this biscuit, then a larger proportion of his income is going as tax as compared to the high income earner, and as a result of this tax it is majorly impacting the low income earner. Now the second one is the progressive tax, that is it is based on taxable amount of an individual's income. They follow an accelerating schedule. For example, when your income is rising, your tax liability is also rising. And what will be the example of this? The direct income tax. Now the next one is proportional tax. Flat tax, which is levied regardless of income and wealth. So what will be the example? It will be corporate tax of earlier 30% and now 22%, the effective of which is 25.17%. So this corporate rate tax of 22% is applicable to all the corporates, all the companies. So there is a flat tax and it is known as the proportional tax because 22% of their earnings is going as corporate tax. I hope that you have understood the difference between these taxes. Now moving on to answer the question. So in the question I have asked you that which tax will impact the most to the low income individuals, and as we have seen in the case of biscuits, regressive tax is the answer to this question. Now moving on to the next question for today. The question says Zimbabwe adopted the multi-currency system in 2009 to curb runaway inflation. Runaway inflation is hyperinflation, which peaked at 500% in 2008 and destroyed its local currency. So multi-currency basket means, so out of these options you have to tell me the correct answer. But before disclosing the answer, let us first discuss what SDR is and what multi-currency basket means. Now special drawing rights, this is a supplementary foreign exchange reserve assets defined and maintained by IMF, that is International Monetary Fund. With the collapse of Bretton Woods system in 1973 and the shift of major currencies to floating exchange rate regimes lessen the reliance on SDR as a global reserve asset. I hope that you all remember that what happened during Bretton Woods era and how this SDR came so as to reduce the selling pressure on dollar, the then international reserve of many countries. Now currently value of SDR is based on a basket of 5 currencies and these are the 5 currencies here on which SDR's value is based upon. Now I want to ask a very interesting question related to this, that what is the difference between Chinese renminbi and yuan? I'll be looking forward to your answers in the comment section below. Do not hesitate to answer and do participate. Now let us discuss what currency basket means. So it is a mix of several currency with different weightings. So it is a kind of currency peg. When the domestic currency has lost its value, what the country do is the country pegs its currency to a major basket of currencies or a multi-basket of currencies and peg its domestic currency to that currency basket so that to stabilize its domestic currency, as we have discussed in the question, the case of Zimbabwe. Now let's move back to the question to answer it. The first option says number of international currencies to which value of SDRs is linked, multiple domestic currencies which are linked to USD for their valuation. Third is number of major international currencies to which the external value of domestic currency is linked. Fourth is a combination of currency and coins of domestic denomination. And the last option is multiple domestic currencies which are linked to multiple international currencies of their valuation. So the correct answer as per the discussion we had is option C, that it is a basket of major international currencies to which the domestic currency is pegged or linked. And do not forget to answer the question that I have asked. Now moving on to the next question for today. Now guys, this is a really interesting question. Now the question says a country's central bank performs various activities to manage the exchange rate. When RBI purchases its domestic currency with a view to create artificial demand in times of currency depreciation without affecting the domestic money supply, it is called as. So out of these four options, you have to tell me that which option is used to create artificial demand in case of currency depreciation without affecting the domestic money supply. Now we all know that open market operation means buying and selling of the government securities for the purpose of liquidity. Now there is a confusion between sterilized intervention and unsterilized intervention, which we are going to discuss in the next slide. And this difference is really important as per the finance point of view. So guys, there are two cases in it. Either the currency can depreciate or it can appreciate. Now, I'll be explaining the sterilized intervention in case of currency appreciation, because in depreciation, everything remains the same, the logic, the concept. So try and understand the currency appreciation part very clearly. So when the domestic currency is going up in value, that means it is appreciating. And as you all know, currency appreciation hurts your exports. So in order to maintain the exchange rate, central bank sells its own currency in the market for foreign currency denominated assets. So as a result, your foreign reserves increase. And as it is selling its own currency, that means more and more currency is in circulation now, which thereby means that money supply of your domestic currency has increased. But increasing of money supply has its own related problems, that is, it might increase the inflation in your country. So in order to protect its country, what central bank further do is, central bank can issue T-bills, and this T-bill, what will it do is, that is, it is basically an open market operation followed by the government, and what it does is, it sucks out the additional liquidity from the market, thereby controlling the money supply in the country as a whole. So let's have a look on this as well. Sterilized intervention is, it affects the money supply, which is offset by open market operations, as we have discussed it here. The central bank can intervene without having effects on interest rate, money supply and exchange rates through sterilized intervention. It can be done by open market operation by issuing T-bills in case of excess money supply. And when the opposite happens, that is when the currency is depreciating, the central bank will want to buy its own currency by creating the artificial demand. And as a result, the money supply will go down. So then the government can purchase the T-bills from the market to put liquidity in the market. Now, it buys or sells domestic or foreign currency and buys or sells bonds in the open market as per the case, that is as per the depreciation or appreciation of the currency. Now, This is what happens in sterilized intervention. But what is an unsterilized intervention, as the name suggests? That it intervention which affects the money supply, that is, there is no offsetting of the money supply. So when here the money supply was increased, and if after that no T-bills, no open market operations is conducted, then till here this is the unsterilized intervention. But if the government chooses to offset this by open market operations, that will come under the sterilized intervention. So I hope that you have understood the difference between sterilized and unsterilized intervention. Now moving back to the question. So when RBI purchases its domestic currency with a view to create artificial demand in terms of currency depreciation without affecting the domestic money supply, it is called as sterilized intervention. Now moving on to the next question for today. RBI extends the liquidity adjustment facility to which of the following financial institutions? So firstly, let's discuss the answer, and then we'll understand that what liquidity adjustment facility is, and we'll differentiate it from the marginal standing facility. So the answer to this question is primary dealers and commercial banks excluding RRBs, that is regional rural banks. So option D, that is both B and C, is the correct answer here. Now let's understand this through an example. Suppose there is a bank and RBI has mentioned the SLR requirement to be at 19%. So if this bank has government securities of 28%, so if it have to borrow from RBI, it can borrow up to 9%. That is the difference between 28% and 19%. And this is known as the repo transaction, because this bank has 9% over and above the SLR, and this government security could then be pledged to RBI and this bank can take the loan from it. So this is the case of liquidity adjustment facility. But what if this bank doesn't have 28%? It has say 18% or 19%. So this bank doesn't have any government securities to pledge to RBI so as to borrow from it. So another facility is provided by RBI to such type of banks, that is the marginal standing facility, wherein when the liquidity has been dried up in the banks, this facility can be used. But then RBI will lend to such type of banks at a rate higher than the repo rate. So I hope that you have understood what MSF and what LAF are, and the difference between these two facilities, because often the students get confused between these two facilities. And if you have any further doubt, then do ask me in the comment section below. Now moving to the next question. The question says the slope of yield curve gives an idea of future interest rate changes and economic activity. Yield curve is a line graph drawn using the following data of a particular instrument. So see guys, this is the maturity period and this is the yield. Normally, the yield curve slopes upwards and it is known as a normal yield curve. So what does it mean? That the securities with the short-term maturity provides you less yield than the securities with the long-term maturity. And this is very logical, because longer the maturity of a security, greater will be the risk, and in order to offset that risk, higher required rate of return and thereby higher yield is provided on those securities. So there can be inverted curve as well or a flat curve as well, but generally you can see this type of yield curve. So the answer to this question is yield and maturity period. So with this, we have completed 5 questions for today. I hope that you like the video and the questions that we have discussed. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel for more regular updates. Thank you for watching the video.